What is going on, guys? Wiser here, and coming to you with OneHive Labs Next Slate, my base episode. I believe we're on episode 12, so that means I'm here with my good friend Kadek. How you doing, man?
Hey, man. Glad to be back.
Yeah, glad to have you, and glad to get another one of these episodes in. Sort of still kind of tweaking the format. We decided that we're going to stop showing those bases that we were initially showing that had some glaring issues that we were just doing a quick breakdown of, because we feel we can get more benefit out of talking now that we're going to be doing the scout views, and neither of us are going to know where the bases traps are that we're going to be hitting in the friendly challenge. We believe that the post discussion of where things ended up being and maybe what caused things to go wrong or whatever, that will have more benefit in the end, and just be more fun at the same time. So one thing I did want to mention, though, guys, is I do want you to keep sending the bases, wiseroh@outlook.com. We are pretty much caught up on a lot of them. There's only a handful of really bases we haven't gone through. So part of the reasoning is there are some very glaring issues that just tell us you haven't gone through the base building series fully. Because there's things that we talk about that you're still doing, things like spring traps. I don't know any other one. Like what most glaring things, Cad, do you see in bases?
Giant bomb placements. That's a big thing. Air defenses being in bad spots. Those are the most obvious things that usually tell. Tell the quality of a base builder, really.
Yeah, and we spot those things fairly quickly, right? When we see the full view of your base, not that they're not terrible bases. That's not what we're saying, but we just know you haven't gone through the fine tuning that the base building series offers. So please revisit that, do some tweaks, send those bases wiseroh@outlook.com. And we'll definitely get you going because, like I said, we're basically caught up. So let's hop on over and check out base number one. So this is the base that I will be hitting. Kadek has built this for me. It's going to be we're going to kind of give both of our perspectives because Cad knows where the traps are, at least for the most part, right? I know for my base, I actually forget where a lot of the traps are because I built it 2 days ago and I haven't really looked at it in detail again. Anyhow. So some good things about this base. Overall, I liked it. Now, it had a lot of very windy compartments. First thing you obviously notice is this section right here with that dead zone separates that queen very well, and she's actually very well protected. While we're speaking of the queen chamber, you know, you got four nice high HP structures sort of all on the outside. The 2-point defense arch towers and an expo and the defensive king in there. So she's really well protected. I like that. There wasn't a glaring spot for me to just say, I'm going to go in here. But what's your perspective if you're just looking at a scout view as best as you can and knowing where the traps are?
Yeah, it's kind of tricky to tell from my perspective now. But the first things I always look at when hitting a base, because I'm always, well, most of the time, I'm still a ground attacker, at least in scrims I am. So I always look at double bomb spots first. And I see two viable double bomb spots.
Yep.
Those are those two. And there's a couple of spots that can have a single bomb, like over here, there could be one over there, one over there at the south, and there could be something going on around this wizard tower. And that should only be one giant bomb because it's on the outside. The wizard tower that is.
Yep.
So looking at these spots, to me, this giant bomb set is the most likely.
It's so furthest away from the queen, right?
Yes,
it's,
and because of those single spots, I think I would, if I had to guess, I think that one would be the place where I would guess GB would be.
Especially because more and more bases are going with a double and two singles. However, one thing I mentioned when we were talking about it, as an attacker, you still have to address both spots.
Yep.
Like they're there, right? Like you can't just guess and say, okay, well, that one more than likely is the active one. You still have to address both positions. You can't just throw a bunch of hogs at it and hope it's not there.
Yeah, and that's one. This is the main reason why I'm always an advocate of having many possible DGB spots in your base. Because right now we have to address two double set spots. Imagine if it's three.
Mm-hmm.
it makes it that much harder to hit a base when fresh hitting it.
Yep, absolutely. Now, one thing I had thought, I believe, I don't know, I think there's something funky going on in this core. I don't believe, I mean, because he's got the dead zone, I feel like there's a Tesla or something in there, at least. I kind of thought there was probably a Tesla helping protect over at 9 o'clock. I mean, it's first hit, right? So you're just guessing. I mean, he could even have something in that dead zone, four Teslas lined up in a row, but I don't know the viability of that overall, because you're going to get huge value out of a kill squad going in that direction. air defense placements, they're all very well protected. I couldn't really find a spot where I could walk or charge in a reasonable fashion that would net me any sort of value out of trying to get some air defense and going with an air attack.
You know what's funny? Now I look at it in a different way.
I mean,
I just see a different jump than before.
Oh,
I
mean, really?
If you have this jump over here and have an entry at the queen, it's a bit of an iffy one, but this air defense can be targeted by a queen in the
chamber.
Queen apartment. So if a queen is standing over here, she can actually target that and follow the kill squad down towards the sweeper, so you could defuse all giant bombs that way with one jump only. So that's actually very interesting. I mean, that could leave you two heals for the back end.
Or,
and that does address all of the giant bombs.
Yeah, it does.
Sorry for throwing your plan away.
No.
I'm just thinking out loud here.
That's interesting. Well, I mean, look at, I mean, well, when, especially when we show up the base that you're going to attack, I mean, we talked about four or five different ways that we potentially could attack something, because that's true with any base, guys. I mean, now, not always does your army comp necessarily fit the base. However, there's definitely many different army comps that can be successful against a base, right? So.
Yes, absolutely.
Now with that entry, I mean, I was just, when you mentioned that, I was thinking one jump max attack style and end up netting, you know, that section at least as the outer edge of the ring and just,
yeah, or go even
and just crazier it.
Depending on the CC content and have a quake over there.
Or a quake. Wow.
That opens up all four artifacts in the end.
Lock in. Yeah. Hmm. Hmm.
I haven't seen that before. So that's an interesting way to look at the base. I mean, you would likely still need to bring a Lava Hound if you were to air attack this, just because of this angle. It's so good to have a Lava Hound fly over.
Yeah.
But it does cover most of the bases. Most of the base.
Huh. That's very interesting. You could probably do that max attack style, just shattered, and bring a max Hound in your CC and only one other Hound and extra balloons.
Yeah, that was my idea.
Yeah. Cool. Well, I don't have balloons built, so that's unfortunate. But
well, it's a cool idea to talk about still.
Yeah, absolutely. Overall, though, I thought it was a really good base. You know, you got two good DGB spots. The clan castle is sort of buried there. The queen is very separated and very protected at the same time. There's a lot of smaller compartments, but you don't really, I mean, other than that section you just had circled with that EQ, there's not a lot of super valuable or super easy compartments that you can either EQ or jump and exactly know where everything's going to go, because it's so, once you get in there, it's kind of a mess.
Yep. So one last thing I wanted to talk about in scout view is spring traps. I mean, looking at it, I see not too many spots where they're actually viable.
Yep.
I mean, there could be two there even. There could be one or two here. There could be one or two here. Something over here. So most likely, from the scout view only, most of the spring traps have to be at the south or at that 11 o'clock section. Unless there's a Tesla with a spring trap, of course. But I thought that's very interesting. I mean, this is one of the ways to scout a base for good spring traps and decide how you want to deploy your hogs. Because, for example, right now, I could decide to drop my hogs in like this and evade two potential spring trap locations.
Yep. Yeah, In fact, like really, when you're going in with any sort of kill squad, whether it's at the Queen Chamber, you start feeding hogs in surgically on the point defense. Well, you're definitely gonna do something like that, and essentially making that completely useless.
Yep, I think so too.
Yeah, that's actually, and we're gonna bring this up again in the base that I built for you, because the way it's set up, it has a couple more of these long alleyways, and it really isn't. You kind of have to do it in certain spots, but they're just very inefficient because it opens things up to surgical hogs so easily, because you know
Yeah.
everything's gonna go down at the same time. Nothing's gonna path in between. You have no worries of traps. That's it, right?
Yep. So let's go over your plan and move to
Sure.
the next place.
So my idea, I'm gonna charge in from 6 o'clock. Kind of can't see it. It's at the bottom of my screen right now. Healers are actually gonna go on the right side. I gotta check the distance. If this archer tower is in range of a wizard on sort of this corner of that lab, which I don't think it is, now that I'm looking at it, I want to funnel this lab off. So if the arch tower is in range, I'm going to bring a giant and drop it first. If it's not, then I'll probably just scrap the giant and use it maybe for the hogging portion. Anyhow, so actually, you know what? I'm going to drop it there anyways, for the reason being it's going to aggro that whiz tower, and then
Yeah,
I can immediately
that's
wall
smart.
break.
Yeah.
So I'll do that. Giant whiz. Wallbreakers, open it up, and then I'm going to drop another whiz. Well, maybe not quite that angle. I just did that so you could see it. But wizard on that, once that arch tower is firing at the queen. And then the queen should walk right in. And as soon as these sort of outer defenses are down and that air defense is free, I might even send in an early one. But send in a hog here, get the lure out. As soon as the lure comes out, I'm going to start the other side of my entry, which is a golem. Probably something like that. Two wizards there. And once everything's locked onto the golem, I'm also, sorry, gonna get a super early, if not just pre-poison, for the heroes right there. And then drop a bunch of Valkyries in between here. They're gonna break all those buildings down. King's gonna go in. They're gonna bust this wall open. Since there's no, I mean, these buildings along that 6 o'clock, it's not really any spots for small bombs. So I have four wall breakers, so I'll probably have an extra one I can drop and just help the Valks beat through that wall very quickly. Everything's gonna go in. I'm going to jump cleanly. Do not want to connect anything else. Right there, I am going to get a heal spell down. I guess it kind of depends where Teslas pop and how fast that golem dies. But I don't think I need to use my first heal until at least they've taken that jump and are getting beat by that expo. I might even be able to shift that up, because I would like to have a jump for, or sorry, a heal for that section. I should be changing colors, but so we're gonna try and heal something like this, I think. That seem realistic?
I think so. Yeah. I'm not going to spoil anything, so I'm going to
Fair
be
enough.
quiet here.
Yep. My reasoning for that is when I look down at this compartment, which is really the idea, like the queen's going to take out that, right? So the kill squad taking out that basically 3 o'clock through to the 10 o'clock means that's the only compartment left. Well, the way I'm going to deploy my hogs is once everything's taken that jump and this archer tower and cannon start shooting at the Valks, I'm going to go 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and that should leave me six more hogs for the end of the raid, which I can probably use for probably this archer tower, something like that. Those hogs are going to be situational depending on where the Valks end up and how the Queen's doing and where the Teslas pop.
So you're gonna have three rages. I mean heals, sorry.
No.
One rage and two heals.
One rage. One rage, two heals, one jump. That circle was just circling the compartment that was going to be left over. That
Yep.
was not a spell.
Okay.
Yeah. So that's my plan.
Wanna go hit it and talk about this base or discuss my base.
Nope. First. Let's talk about yours. It's just easier. Okay.
Yeah. It is.
Yeah.
Okay, so let me switch bases here.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me when it's up. Should be up.
We're good to go. Yep.
Nice. So the alleyway we were talking about earlier, that's this alleyway, and that's really the bane of the existence of this base. But first things first, when I'm looking at this base, when I'm scouting it, the first thing I saw when scouting this base is the one double set spot there is in the base, and that's over here next to the king. That's the only real viable DGB spots in the base. So my plan revolves around that DGB and the queen, basically. If I remember correctly, this guy told about this being an anti-HB.
Yeah, let me give you a quick history here. So this was one of, like I said, we're caught up on a lot of emails. So I started looking at some of the newer ones. Like there's still some in between, but I was looking at literally some we got this week, and one of them, this guy specifically, had said he was trying to build a base that was would defend against HDHB, because it's obviously the thing right now. It's so overpowered. And actually, I will, once you make the hit, Cad, I'll give you a little more details on why he thought that. I just obviously don't want to tell you that, because it's
going to
reveal some things about it. However, we talked about, Kadok and I, well, what do? Do we show that it can still be HDHB, or do we show that because you're trying to defend one thing, it probably makes your base weaker elsewhere? And we came to the conclusion that Cad's plan is actually going to get a lot more value because of the way he had to
do the layout.
So,
yeah. So the thing about this base is I wanted to show a non-HGHB attack first. If I have to clean it up, I'm most likely still going with the HGHB. But I'm this alleyway, it's very easy to lure a queen in there. I mean, I just need to drop her up there, funnel this army camp, and then she should like meander her way in there. Maybe a little bit more funneling over there might be smart to do. I'm not sure if it's even needed. So I'm going to break her in here at the top and walk her down that alleyway, just because it's going to defuse the DGB over here. And look at all of the point defenses it's getting as well. And I most likely only need to invest one rage, just because of the start here, and can do the lure. Haven't really looked at it, but most likely over here should be fairly easy. So that's basically the plan. But first, let's go back to where I think bombs and Teslas are. So the DGB is fairly obvious to me, if there is a DGB, of course. And then there's only a few real spots left for a bomb. So one at the south here and something up at the top. I mean, that's the way to spread your bombs well. And I assume this this base has that. So this is how I would expect the bombs to be. Keep in mind, this has to be a Tesla if there's a bomb there. So that's one of my Tesla guesses. Another one would be here on the outside, if that makes sense. I'm not too sure about that, but it could help lure giants away from going into the base. So that's one of my thoughts on that Tesla. And if I had to guess for Tesla farm, I would guess it like in this section, or Tesla over here, Tesla over here, Tesla over there. So if there's a farm, I would most likely think it's at the south. But that's me. I'm not sure. You can't tell me. Please don't tell me.
Yeah.
So for giant bombs, this is the way I would expect them. And another thing I saw, I need to check ranges in-game for this still. But I think that the Archer Tower over there is a good one-for-one trade. I think I could get that. I'm not too sure, since a loon these days has to get two drops off instead of just one.
It does, I believe.
Yeah, so that might be a bit tricky, but I think I can pull it off if there's nothing there.
And just to clarify, sorry, someone in the last video, guys, when we say one for one trade, we mean using one loon, usually, or even sometimes one hog, on a defense, and basically trading your balloon for the defense. And that trade is worth it every time.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah.
Because it weakens the base in such a way that, if you do the math, it's a valuable trade.
Absolutely. Yeah.
So The only thing I would not usually do it for is mortars, because they don't do anything except for kill wall breakers right now.
But they're splashing those giants under the healers, man.
Oh yeah, man, I'm impressed. So next up is spring traps. I'm just going to draw them in where I expect them, expect where they could be. So there could be something there. There could be something here, and something here. So these are pretty much all of the viable spring trap spots. And the thing I noticed when checking out this base, I mean, look at this section. Like, pretty much all of the valuable traps are in that area.
Yep.
So from that perspective, the most viable strat, in my opinion, is to go with a simple Goho on this base, Govaho. Like, two golems, breaker in, have a double jump for the kill squad, like one over here, one over here. One golem will most likely move like this, so it should do the tanking fairly well. Just bring a lot of Valks. I mean, heal them on the way, of course. They need to heal fairly early. Support with a few hogs. The only thing that could mess this up is like the Teslas over here, and they could be there, so I would need to invest more hogs if they were there. That should get me to the queen and leave me with one heal for the rest of the base. So most likely that would mean, oh, let me switch shapes. I could use a heal at the top or use it at the bottom if the Tesla's popped there with hogs. So if I were to go into a real war raid, I think I would bring one giant for the 2 o'clock section, surgical the hogs in, just two per defense and one two. And this is what we talked about, a very easy surgical hog deployment.
Yeah, that was about the alleyways. And this base is surrounded by them, right? Like,
yeah, so this is perfect for surgical hogs.
Now,
you can even have the one hog in here at 3 o'clock.
And a huge, what I was going to say is it all aligns to what you just drew out, right? If this bottom section has that kind of value and is the most sensible entry, leaving what I just drew around the base is where you would have to hog, right? But that
yeah, and that's so easy because I can directly target all of them.
Yeah.
So that's the disadvantage. I mean, box spaces are good at tunnel 10, but at tunnel 9 they make stuff easy.
Yep. And so, I know, like, when you say box base, like, obviously this isn't a box base, but in a sense it is.
It resembles it a bit.
It resembles it in the way you have to place your structures because of the wall layouts, and it's, yeah.
So this is what I expect of the base, but I decided, I think it's very valuable to show this queen walk I talked about. Like, start her up top, funnel her in a bit. I may even have to switch out for a baby dragon to funnel this. I haven't decided yet. I might just clear this first collector. Should be fine. But I'm going to wall break her here up top and charge her right in there. And if I do, I can clear most of those defenses. And what I'm getting, let me draw it out, is essentially this section of the base, including the DGB. So if I do that, I can have this army comp basically, and only bring like very few hogs. And that's what I'm actually gonna do. I'm gonna be really ballsy and only bring about 8 hogs.
Now, my only real concern is the amount of time it's gonna take to do that and get the CC pulled out so you can send in the rest.
Yeah, absolutely. So that is an issue, but I think it's very valuable to show this queen walk that it's possible, because if that queen walk is possible, and I think it is, it also opens up your base to dragon attacks. So let me clear stuff up. If I can eliminate these two air defenses, king can fairly easily be brought in here to take out that air defense, and I can zapquake the last one, and that leaves nothing of the base really. So I can just send in my dragons and have something for the bottom end, and that's the whole base.
Mm-hmm.
So that's the last thing I wanted to talk about. This base is weak to dragon attacks, also because of the sweeper placement, because this one, what's it going to do for you, really?
Yep.
I mean, the only reason why that sweeper would be there if there's actually Teslas here.
Hmm. Yep.
Does make sense. Yeah, if they're there, it doesn't matter too much, really. For my attack, at least. That, that's why. I think I'm just going to go with the double golem entry. Very few hogs, so it's very risky. So, yeah, it, this is not a good way to attack this base, let's be real. But I think it's cool to show everything that I can on this base and how it would work.
Yeah, like, you probably wouldn't be doing this as your secure attack in one of our arranged wars.
No, then I would go for the double jump, go for owl any day.
Or probably just the HGH. Yeah. Let's be honest, Cad, yeah, come on.
Because, because the HGH, just to point it out, the queen, I need to check this range in-game, but if you drop giants there, is she going to jump out? There's a fat chance she is. So... if she's going to jump out early, then I can just funnel with wizards like this and start the HB at that side. If they break in by themselves, perfect, because they're going to walk up towards 12 o'clock once they broke in. I mean, of course, I'm going to need to kill that Archer Tower, but it will be distracted by the giants, so my wizards will be able to take it out.
The Town Hall is even a nice little breadcrumb for your bowlers to stand on for a second while everything gets funneled.
Yeah, exactly, so I can drop my bowlers in quite easily. Need to pre-poison the queen, of course, but once that's done, I can rage this area while dealing with the CC. And then my giants and bowlers are just in, and I just have to watch where they go. And same story, this is easy surgical hog deployment all around the base, so wherever they go, I can just support them. So if I were to go with the easiest triple, I think I would still HGHB this base, even though this is an anti-HGHB base. So, yeah.
Yeah.
Kind of sucks. I hate
Don't get discouraged. The reason I pick this base is because at least... I love the fact that there's viewers out there, and I know everyone's talking about this. Like, how do you defend it right now? And
you
it's not easy. And I'll tell you straight up, I was actually talking to someone on Twitter today. Someone had said something about how to nerf bowlers to make it better, and I had chimed in. In my personal opinion, you increase bowler troop space to 7 and minor troop space to 5, and it would make that subtle difference that might balance it. Might not.
Or maybe just back to 8. I mean, they buffed them and reduced troop space, and that's the crazy part.
Yeah. So, I mean, it's hard right now, guys. I'm like, oh, anyways. So, I say this, and then someone was like, or people just build bases to defend them. I'm like, okay, well, I'd like to see that. I mean, 90% of your troops are just spammed up the middle, and you win. So, I don't think that's a base building issue, really. It's a it's a troop issue. So the response was this. I shit you not. This is the exact response. But Go Wee Wee used to 3-star bases, and now bases defend it. I'm like, I didn't respond to it. I'm like, okay, whatever.
Yeah, but at the same time, it's similar. It actually is, because you're spamming troops in, and you're saving a few troops for the back end. This is back to the basics at the start of competitive wars.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So I think it's, in a way, it's actually similar, even though I don't like to promote GoWiiWii decks.
But yeah. I will say, witches never 3-star Town Hall 10s and 11s. And when they did, they got nerfed very quickly.
Yeah, so I hope the bonus get nerfed quickly. That's all I'm going to say.
To a point. And I don't want them, like, hacked in half. I'd like, they just need a little bit of a tweak to just bring them one step down. That's it, right? One step down, give the base builders at least a chance. Because right now, I mean, if the first HGHB attack isn't going to get it, the second one is.
Yeah, absolutely.
So
let's go in game.
Let's do it. Sounds good. Just gotta reload my game. All right, I am in. Oh no, I don't have my troops. Oh yes, I do. Good. 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 So who wants to go first? Now, I was gonna say, we'll each make our first hits, and then we can set up and do the second hits if we have to clean up and show
those.
Yeah,
sure.
You want to do that? Because
the only thing I would need to do is decide if I need a baby dragon, yes or no.
Yep.
I'm not too sure about that.
I only have level one baby dragons.
Can you show me the base in game before we go, and I'll be ready by that time?
Yes.
So I would like you to go first then, just because of the training time. So my CC is ready. Do you need anything still?
I'm set.
I'm issuing the challenge.
Beautiful. Okay, I am just going to do my quick scout view here.
Yeah, I think I can get away with it. Two minions or so at that that one spot.
Yeah, see, that arch tower isn't in range. That's fine. Because their tower is for sure, so giant with... three wallbreakers with all right. Jump. Let's do it. I am going in.
Good luck.
Thank you. 10 to 20 poisons. Good. Right, we are in live. Oh no. 20 seconds. Load. we want this. Okay, sweet. Alrighty, we're going queen. Get that arch tower locked on with three breakers. She's open. Sucks I didn't get that lab down. Should be okay though. Get that rage down.
Nice hog.
The CC. Right, I think she is okay. That she is. And we go. Oh no, I forgot. Oh, that's so bad. I honestly forgot I didn't have a golem in my CC.
Oops. That happens.
Great. Come on. Well, they're going. Get that heal down here. Think I'm gonna do it. Queen got held up there.
Yeah. Well, your queen is going to kill the base. Time is an issue. The Teslas did mess you up a bit, and that's why I didn't say anything, because that one Tesla next to the queen, both of them actually are fairly nasty.
I wasted those Valks in my CC though because of that.
And that's also a thing. I mean, they make you panic on a first hit. But then again, with 30 seconds left, you almost had it. So I think with minor adjustments and maybe even having to drop the golem at first instead of the Valks might have actually been the difference in the 3-star here.
Yeah, I was thinking 99% here. Actually.
Yeah, it's...
Actually.
No, you're not getting it. The Wizard Tower will live.
Come on. Oh, come on.
No.
Why are you kidding me? Are you kidding me?
Wow. Like, sliver. I think you would have had it with the Valks not being dropped at first.
Yeah.
Honestly, I think so.
Ay, ay, ay.
That's nasty.
Oh, man.
I'm so sorry for you.
No, no worries. No worries. I usually have, you know what? I was farming all day and I had a golem in my CC all day.
Yeah, that happens.
And it was like that natural habit. Alrighty. You're up, my friend.
Yeah.
Do I need to reissue
it? So, honestly, no, you don't need to. Honestly, I think my hit will fail. I'm going to be honest.
Oh, now that you looked at the ranges?
I was checking the ranges. But my two minions should be able to clear it both sides. I should be able to clear it with minions. So that's nice. But I think because of my setup of the army, I have too few hogs to adapt. And I'm someone who really likes to adapt mid-raid. So that's why I always like to bring at least 14 hogs or something as a minimum.
Yeah.
Just so I can adapt to where Teslas pop. And in this case, I actually think they're at 3 o'clock. And if that's the case, that's the worst case scenario for me.
Yeah, that's so, the lightest part of the base. That's where the queen's getting to at the end of the raid.
At the end of the raid, so she should take care of it, including the enemy king. But my entry might get screwed up because of it. I mean, also, the golem getting towards the mortar does scare me a little bit. Just because of the entry point. But I'm just going to go in, and we're going to see what happens.
Cool.
6 Felks, the 1-for-1 trade on the balloon, couple of minions, and I didn't check my queen funnel properly, but let's hope for the best, right?
Yep.
That's what you always do in Vortex, right? You spam troops, and you hope for the best.
Get confident. Spam and hope for the best.
Yeah, I mean, that's what HEHB does. So, yeah.
Giants. Healers, bowlers, go have a smoke.
Yeah, I'm in.
All right, he's in live, guys. Here we go.
Okay, drop the queen, drop the minion, and wait for the archer tower to lock on. There it is. So she walks perfectly, actually. Oh, there's a small red bomb there. That's fairly nice. But as you see, oh, let me wall break first. Okay, so that messed me talking there messed up my wall breakers. That kind of sucks.
So she's gonna charge in. Oh no way!
Nope, she's not going to.
Oh wow! I thought those things were gonna get it.
Completely adapt here. She might actually aggro the enemy queen. So let's just let her do her thing. And I didn't even check the lure range, but let's see.
Oh no!
It works. Nice, perfect.
Yeah, right on the edge.
So I'm gonna double poison that. Probably a waste of the second poison. Just use the ability. Let's see if I can still do this. I mean, there's no... Yeah, see? The enemy queen engages. That's nice. Okay, so I need to go with my golems now. Boom, boom. Funnel it off. So my queen is safe and doing well, actually. That's awesome.
Yeah, I think you're looking good. CC's pulled defensive queens down. I mean... We didn't get to show the alleyway we were hoping in this show, but it's all good. Fine.
So the Valks are going in. I support it with some hogs. I didn't even need the rage, so I can just rage right now. I'm just going to support with hogs earlier than I expected to. Yeah, see, the one Tesla was there.
Oh, and your jump That's was a little bit late. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, it was way late. My jump was way late. So I'm still going to heal them. So my 1-for-1 trade did nothing, really. That's kind of funny.
Oh, I missed it. Oh, you still have the loon.
I tried to push it in.
Mm.
Well, this is becoming quite a crazy raid. I might still get
56
it.
56 seconds. There's a couple of Teslas. They're about to go down.
One hero Hulk is getting defenses. Springtrap, yeah.
I think you got it, man. All the point defense are going down right now.
Yeah, I still got Velks. So they might do the hero work. No, I think that's too much cleanup to do, really. Oh, my queen's walking outside.
30 seconds.
Oh, that should be it then. Awesome.
I think you got it, bro.
I think I got it.
Everything's targetable by that queen down there.
Yep. Time might still get me.
25 seconds to beat through that. What? The wall's weakened already, too.
Yeah,
you got it. You got it.
No. Nope, I don't got it.
Come on, oh, no way! Oh, like, she didn't walk around! Well. Like, she didn't walk around. Let's zoom in on this right now. Okay, she is completely in range. If she just walked down to this corner, or rocked around the corner, she would be in range.
Oh, well. Hey, that's nice, man. 299%.
Wow. Are you kidding me? Okay, so here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to just put a pause on the video here in a moment while Kadok and I kind of regroup and get our cleanups planned, and we will be back. Sound good?
Yep.
Beautiful. We will be right back. All right, guys, so we are back. So here actually is the Twiddlers of all the traps, the full view. Everything pretty much what we talked about, right? Double giant bombs, both in the spots that we had talked about. There was actually a Tesla. That screwed me up a little bit. Did not allow me to get that lab down, but it didn't really matter. The CC troops ended up sucking me right in. Anyways, my biggest issue was I completely forgot I took Max Valks in my CC instead and dropped them first right here. So then the Tesla and Archer Towers locked onto them, and I basically wasted them. I basically used them to funnel off. I basically used three Valks to funnel off a storage. So that was a big waste.
But the Tesla over here, it's funny, because this is a very obvious way to enter a base. And if the golem walks up towards the Tesla and you don't wall break in time, the golem will actually move over towards the cannon. So I thought that was a very nice touch, and I did not want to spoil that for the first hit. So
yeah, no, absolutely. I still think I'm going to go with that. Even if my golem walks to that cannon, I think it's okay because everything will be laid down and my Valks will be going in and joining the golem. And all that golem's going to do is tank for my hogs. And it should lock that expo on, right? And help things out as they move along. I think, honestly, with the very slight adjustment of just dropping my golem, I am going to bring a second giant here. Well, it was bringing extra. Well, so hard to say.
Yeah, it's tough. The one thing I didn't see before, but still, no, it's not going to happen still. Never mind. I thought this could be a one-for-one loon trade to make sure that funnel goes down, but this expo can lock on as well as the Archer Tower, so I don't think it will get it. But, with maybe a barb in front, I think you could get it if you drop a barb first and then drop the loon.
That's interesting.
So that's an interesting idea.
See, I don't mind that cannon too much
because it's an idea that you do need to keep in mind when designing a golem trap like this, that this defense basically is hard to take out, because right now if I can get like a six troop space funnel right there, that might be worth it for me to clear that to be sure that my golem goes in.
I see what you're saying. All right, so
let's go over the base quickly. I like the Teslas. These Teslas are quite obvious, but that's not a big deal. I mean, someone still has to guess whether they're in the core next to the queen or right there where they
exactly
are.
Literally, like, you could record my words right now when I was talking about the base. I said, I'm like, there's something fishy going on here, but who knows about there? And you just don't know. Who knows about the core? I was wrong. I thought there was going to be at least something in the core, and there was not.
So the big disadvantage of not having anything in the core is obviously the golem avalanche, because I could jump and jump the end. So that's one of the big things I saw about this base when looking at it. I mean, I can still drop a golem here or even up here and wall breaker, have this golem walk down it, that's fine. It just needs to tank for the wizards going around. So this is a base, because there's nothing in the core, that's kind of prone to being a golem avalanched.
Yep. But overall, not bad.
It's not bad. The spring traps are good. The one thing I did want to mention is there's three over here. I'm not too big of a fan of that.
Yeah, now that's why
there's a bit too many, especially with this queen charge. I mean, you saw it happen, it works. So you can defuse the DGB and the spring traps from the same location.
One other adjustment I'm going to make, and actually those little bombs worked in my raid. I healed more like down here. I did not heal those hogs, and they took those four bombs and a couple splash damage from those Wiz Towers, and I lost a lot of hogs there, actually, with the combination of that Skelly Trap. So yeah, good job with that. That's another adjustment I'm going to make, is I'm probably just going to heal that right there. Just almost overlap the heals for the Valks and then the Hogs, and then hopefully everything will move into now this part, basically full health, and try and hang on to a few extra Hogs for that Tesla compartment at the end.
Yeah, and because the Queen ends up there, it should be fine.
Yeah.
Otherwise, you do need a plan for that back end, and that's why I like the Tesla placing there.
Yep.
Because you're still forcing a plan for that area. So this Spring Trap, it's good, but if you look at the Hogs, they're most likely coming in from this angle. So a spring trap over there from any angle is better.
Yep.
Except for when they're coming in like this. That's the only case where it isn't better. But for most cases, I believe that moving that spring trap is better. So just a small detail, but it does make a difference. Anything else I see? Yeah, the thing I didn't like about this base is having one black bomb or black mine at each air defense. So against dragons, obviously that's very good, but versus loon it isn't, because you want to pop a hound as quickly as possible, so they are forced to send in two hounds early. And so basically what I would like to see is to have like bombs like this, for example, and remove that one and remove this one.
Yeah. Now what we talked about, that shattered entry, a jump here and just a shattered entry. I don't know how far you'd have to go, but I'm pretty confident you could drop a golem there, a golem there, do your funneling. Now
wall breaker,
good placement on the small bombs, but again, wall breaker, and it's just like a typical, you know, the queen standing directly in between those two air defense. I know that's hard to avoid, but there's nothing
really stopping you. But the at the same time, these red bombs are straight in the path of a lava hound, so that needs some changing. The second lava hound is going to come in like this, most likely, or just from the other side, actually, because of that sweeper.
And then same goes. I kind of like the idea of the whiz towers there, but you're like even yeah.
Yeah, you're gonna have to come in with two hounds. So I think this is the most likely path of the first one. And this will be the path of the second one, and the third one scouted will have to come in like that. So this might be a nice setup, but at the same time, I can just drop one loon in, have them pop, and then reinforce, or just let my loons die out over there, because there's no splash damage there.
Yeah.
So all the splash is here with that wizard tower, and that's most likely going to go down at the start.
I'd have to check the ranges, but I almost feel like a mini even on that elixir mine on the outside of there would trigger at least one of them.
Might be. I'm not sure.
Anyhow.
So good base overall. I like it. There's a couple of details. I mean, both DTGB spots were very obvious. That's one thing that you can improve on. I mean, this is where it does get difficult, honestly, to design a base where they're not obvious. But it can be done, so I would focus on that. And right now, if you can defuse this with a Queen Walk or somehow, and defuse this, then you could even Mass Hog the back end, just because of the bombs are gone.
Yeah.
So this is one of the reasons why DGB with two singles is so popular, because you could still like have a giant bomb over here, for example, that would screw up the raid even more, because you're forcing the heal early because of the Skelly Trap and the bombs, but then again force another heal over there. And this DGB, the only thing why that would really work is if someone is just neglectful of that side of the base, really. I don't see a real case where you would have that go unchecked. And even if, I mean, you could queen walk the first section and then send in like four or five hogs and then have them go like this and over. I mean, why not invest the five hogs there? I mean, not many people are going to do this. I mean, That's just how it is, but it's possible. I mean, I think that DGB is quite weak and is stronger when split up.
Absolutely.
So that would be the main feedback on this base. I like it. It's a good base. Yeah, keep up the good work, man. It's a good base.
All right, let's move on to yours.
Yep.
299%. Are you kidding me?
It's so funny.
Are you kidding me? One shot from an Archer Queen. That's all I needed. I honestly think her bolt from her X-Bow was mid-air, like it was on path to the Wizard Tower.
You're salty. I like it. Okay, so the other base, this spring trap is as expected. These two spring traps are as expected. This one was obvious. So the spring traps were fairly obvious, but once again, there's less in the bottom side than I expected, honestly. But still, this section of the base, if you clear it, that's three giant bombs. I didn't even trigger this one, but that's more because of how the raid actually went than me not triggering it. But I believe that my entry will disable three giant bombs and four spring traps. And that's going to cripple your base, especially if I actually did the double jump, how I talked about. That would be all four giant bombs gone.
Yeah.
This is better value than I even anticipated.
So I'll give you the rundown. The things he was talking about was the entries with an HGH. He's like, if you drew it out, he's like, if you drew it on this side and beat in through the wall. First of all, part of the reason he created those alleyways is to create the double layer of walls to force you to bring jump spells instead. But as we talked about, that doesn't really matter. You know, it's like you're usually swagging rages as is. But this little action here, the idea was he's got these bombs in the middle, but either the giants are going to path away from it, essentially leaving bowlers
going up. They are going to go, yeah, okay. Yeah.
Leaving bowlers going up through the middle and triggering those bombs as they start getting hit by
stuff. Yeah, but my big issue with that is, first of all, the bowlers are going to hit this, and with that, like, they're going to come in from this angle. So they're most likely going to take out both of those buildings, then get lured down over there, take out those two, and then
they won't even jump in there.
They won't even jump in there. There's no reason for them, except for maybe the Archer Queen pad, but they can't reach it, so they move up towards the Tesla and the Elixir storage.
Yep.
So honestly, I don't see it happening, and I'm actually going to try this angle, mostly because the queen is going to step out, as we saw in my raid.
You get her right away, engage. Pretty much as soon as the bowlers go down, or even your arch queen.
Yeah, so that's the big deal, and this is what you talked about. This is also the forcing of jump spells. This is the merits between the older style of Queen Chambers and the newer style, which is the wall investment over here is so big. Yeah. I mean, there's so many walls invested there that the entry from the other side of the base, it just makes it easy and natural.
Yeah.
So that's the issue about all of those walls. Now, again, we might need to do this. I think it's a good idea, honestly, because as you talked about, it forces a weird angles for HGHB to come in at, and it makes it more difficult. But I think right now the path is very clear where the giants are going to go, and the healers should most likely follow.
And as we talked about, super easy surgical out on the outsides here. Everything's going to just wrap around, go clockwise. Another thing I talked about in recaps is so many Clash of Clans attacks are basically what you're trying to do is have your troops come together and all move in a unison rotation, either clockwise or counterclockwise.
Yeah, right? And the theory behind that is very easy, and that's also what you try to prevent as a base builder. If you have one small sized ball of death that survives, you're only going to encounter one defense at a time, pretty much. The same thing is with a queen walk. That's why I tried this entry, to only encounter one point defense at a time. So that's the thing about this. So that's also the reason why you want to have storage inside of your base with a lot of defenses targeting the troops. So that's one thing I really liked about this base. That's the swords are very spread out all around the base.
Yeah, I noticed that too, actually.
And that's very well done. So yep. I think this is a really good base. The one thing I absolutely don't like, never place a giant bomb next to your queen. Why? The bolus might walk in, sure. But the healers, they're under rage. That means that the giants are full HP. They most likely, at least one of them will split towards the bolus. So even if they go in, they will have a healer on them and only one expo on them likely. This one might also target, but then the healers will just all switch, especially if you're surgical in hogs at that time.
Yeah.
So I think it's still more valuable to put it further away. And honestly, I'm still not sure on how to defend HGHB. I'm still looking for the answer.
And we're getting asked left and right. That's what everyone wants to know right now.
Yeah. And the one key I do see about it is if your healers split from your giants and heroes and you get the enemy troops to split up, basically build a farm base, that's the thing that does work. So the last base we showed, if you can get those giants to walk around, out and around, you have a good shot at defending. So I think the previous base was actually a pretty good example of how you possibly could defend an HGHB.
Yep.
So yeah, I think that's about it. I think pretty much everything is in order in this base. I mean, it's well laid out. This sweeper, I do have an issue with that. We're not big friends because it's not defending anything really. I mean, it would be better served up here, for example, and pointed up. It prevents this queen entry. It forces someone to go in straight at the wall. I was thinking if I were to redo this attack, I would most likely drop a minion there, drop two minions there, and charge her straight in instead of under a weird angle to make sure she goes in.
And then you kind of, at the same time, actually, that move strengthens that and adds, you know, you can move the Teslas a touch. I wasn't a fan though when I put this Tesla here. I'm like, I didn't like it. I looked and I'm like, well, maybe if you moved it up here, it would, but then it screws the DGB up kind of.
Yeah, but right now already the DGB is kind of screwed up because if you do this, they will just go over. Okay, they get sprung up really, real nicely, but they're not going to get too much value. They might even ignore that giant bomb, honestly.
I think they will.
They most likely actually will.
They're not going to go to the wizard towers.
So this is actually disastrous for the base.
Yeah. Yeah.
Still, I don't think a fair play attacker will try this. I mean, who's crazy enough to actually try it? But it's there.
Mm-hmm.
Anything else? All of the red bombs on the outside. That's kind of interesting. This red bomb, did you see what happened on my attack?
Yeah.
If that red bomb would be over here, my minion would have been screwed. I had an extra minion just in case. But just move it over one tile and fat chance that my minion would have died.
Because you got to know when someone's... Think about where someone's going to place a funnel line troop. Like, I think you placed it back there, right? On that second one. You're gonna make sure that it's out of range of those defenses. So, I mean, I would probably favor it like on that corner, sort of. So
Or just over here to cover both.
Yeah. Yep.
It's just a few ideas. This skelly trap was nice. Did work. This skelly trap is nice. I mean, that skelly trap at 3 o'clock lured all of my Velks up there, so that was really nice.
Yeah.
The bad thing is that my jump was still there, and they rerouted.
They went up. Went up and then back down. Yeah.
Yeah. So that was kind of awkward, but it was really nice. A really nice touch. I like it. The disadvantage of this CC is that it's lurable, so in our case we don't get to switch CCs. But this is a fairly easy lure, so you do need a lot of small troops in there to make sure the lure isn't that easy. So just keep that in mind. Other than that, I'm happy with this base. These small bombs don't do much because of these wizard towers. No one's going to be crazy enough to try and wall break that. So right here and right here would be better options. And same goes for up here. If you have the small bombs, place them in those areas, I would say.
Yeah, well, especially the that guy, what we talked about. I really wish that had been success. It was so funny. You're like, ooh, the red bomb, that looks pretty nice. Oh, the arch tower is bad.
Oh, yeah. Oh, well, it happens.
Yeah.
Yeah, so
all right.
I think that wraps it up.
Let's give it a shot then. I'm going to hop on over to the game. Okay, so we are ready to rock here. Oh, CAD's already got me posted. And check my army. Giant. Alright. I think I'm ready to rock. Let's do this. Live. Beautiful. Alright. Just remember the damn golem this time. Right, so let's actually drop the golem this time. Nice, my queen went back out, but my golem walked. Ugh.
But the Valks beat him.
Oh, interesting. Interesting. This down. King is not following. Are there any Valks up there?
Just one.
They disappeared.
The queen killed them. Oh, just two now.
Oh, man. I didn't pre-poison.
Nope.
Ouch. Well, this is not looking so good. Not one bit. Weak.
That angle was nice on the hogs.
Oh, he was like a sliver off. Brutal. I can't believe that. That was horrible.
That happens.
Ugh. Ugh. I don't know what the difference was. Oh well.
Yeah, most of your Valks died early this time instead of the golem tanking for them. I think that went wrong.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, oh well. That's what it is.
I think if your Valks lived, you would have had it this time.
Yeah,
I think both times it actually came down to execution, honestly.
The golem didn't aggro the queen. That was the problem.
That might have been the angle as well.
Yeah.
I'm not sure.
Like, yeah, the golem didn't aggro the queen, so she just had a heyday on the Valks. That's why they beat the
wall. Yeah, I think the angle in which you dropped the golem killed you, actually.
Yeah.
Because if it goes straight to the wall, then you would be fine.
Yeah.
And if not, then it happens what happens. So, I mean, that just goes to show that that queen chamber is actually very tricky to enter into, and that's a very good thing. So, nice job building there.
Yep. Yeah, I needed to drop it further so it stretched across the queen chamber as opposed to just walking right to the Tesla.
Yeah.
Kind of thing. I think that was the ultimate fatality. Ugh, horrible. Oh, well.
Can't get them all.
So no. So hope you can put one up here.
Let me first make sure that my army is ready to go, because it isn't yet. Now it should be done. Let me check. Now I only have rages. That's not gonna work. Well, I should be fine still. So let me see. So the plan I have right now is to go straight at the queen. I kind of do need a heal. I will get it. Whatever. So I'm going to drop the giants, drop a nice white funnel. And there's not much to this raid, honestly, because once you drop your giants, it's just sit back, relax, take a beer, sprinkle and drop some hogs.
Maybe a raid spell here and there.
Yeah, so we know where the giant bombs are now. So most likely I'm going to need a heal for the bottom section, because there's a giant bomb there and the wizard towers, and my hogs will end up there. So what I'm going to do is drop the giants and then drop one sneak hog in. Just because of that one archer tower that's out of range of everything. Or actually, that's going to be the balloon. Sorry. I just wanted to show it. And then, let's see. I'm ready to go. It's let's posted. Do this. Let's go. I'm in.
Good luck, buddy.
So, I'm just going to start off with this loon, just because I wanted to show it. See what happens. You know? So it's actually not going to go down. That's interesting.
No, not quite. Just, and then that second one locked on.
Yeah, but that's
almost
fine. Yeah, but I don't care too much about it, honestly.
One it's hog, one show. Hit. Yeah.
Yeah. So right now, this is actually perfect because I can drop my bolus early because of this queen walking out. So that's actually perfect for me. And see, the bolus are already killing... the start, let's rage up the healers because that's what we need. Start a couple of hogs. I've not done a bowler hit in so long right now. Interesting. Just add some more hogs in.
Yeah. See, even add the one hog there. Even the one bowler that walked in and nothing touched it.
No. So my healers are kind of dying right now. Just need to hit my king's ability, start the cleanup. That's always important.
Ooh, nice spring.
Rage him up once again, just because lost a little bit more than I anticipated. So those air defenses actually do quite a bit this raid. Yeah,
not bad placement. Every wall they get stuck on, they seem to be able to be out of reach almost of the bowlers, but in reach of the healers.
So right now I just need to watch for the...
Oh, you got the two whiz. You got the bowler on the bowlers on the outside. Once they get through that wall,
oh yeah, I can just heal these giants. I don't really need the heal, but I should.
You're golden.
Just
there's
to be
only,
safe.
There's just those wizard towers. You're
fine. Basically.
Definitely.
So the key here was that the queen engaged very early, and I misplaced a couple of things. I mean, I better be honest about that. Yeah, so as soon as the giants go in, you get the queen kill, get the CC kill, then it's pretty much over. So that's what happened here, really.
Yep. Nice job, buddy.
Oh, well, beautiful. Thanks.
Did you roll your face over the screen for that one?
Oh, yeah, I did.
Okay, the highlight of Chicago Live was we were doing, because the war mismatched, mm-hmm. Obviously, all the war attacks, nobody gave a crap about. So that was pretty unfortunate. However, the friendly challenge for both Town Hall 10 versus 10 and 9 versus 9 brackets, those were pretty cool. And we had, especially because 2.0 had such a big representative, like we had all the guys doing friendly challenges at our tables. And people were like shouting out what was going on each attack. Because we did them, we didn't just do friendly challenges. They both hit live like at the same time. Right, so they were going like head to head, and chat did an attack, and we were like, because it was bowlers, obviously, because he's Town Hall 10, and we were like, roll your face over the screen, just do it, just do it. And he actually dropped a rage spell with his nose, and the place went nuts. It was like, ah, that was so awesome,
perfect,
yeah,
nice, that's amazing.
All right, so we've been at this a while, and let's wrap this up. I did just want to re-mention as well, guys, please send us your bases. We're doing our best. We're catching back up now, but do us a favor and go just do a quick scan through even of the base building series. There's a lot of little fundamentals. You know, honestly, if you just watch the hog pathing and trap placement episode, it will do wonders for you, and we're going to be more likely to show your base. Anything else you want to add there, Kadok?
No, I think the bases that are being shown are very good, so nothing against them. The fact that we might triple them is just because that's how it is. at Town Online. Mm-hmm. The only thing you try to do is force user errors like happened in this episode.
Absolutely. I mean, absolutely. That, I got
that's what it's all about. So great job, guys. Keep it up. And yeah, beautiful. I'm looking forward to the next one.
Love it. So let's wrap this up. That'll do it here for your Wisdom from Wiser. Just trying to help you bag that next 3-star. Till then, I'm out.